Good morning, PV, and welcome to an all-new edition of Pvtv. I'm TJ Pellegrin.
And I'm Brianna Oliveira, and here are this week's top stories. The Environmental Club is getting to collect like-new used Halloween costumes for its annual costume booth at Meadowbrook Harvest Festival in October. Costumes are often used just once and either thrown out or put in forever to storage, which is just wasteful. Why not recycle the joy to somebody else? Please have all donations sent to room 122 by Tuesday, October 8th for Meadowbrook Harvest Festival.
On Thursday, October 10th, the video production classes will be holding another bake sale to help raise money for their upcoming LA trip. There will be many fun snacks, including the bestseller, Mega Brownies. Make sure to come check it out.
Over 1.5 students took the 2018 PSAT Merit Scholarship Qualifying Test last October. Only 16,000 students were recognized as semifinalists. New Jersey is one of the hardest states to qualify in, as the index number is the highest of any state. Good luck to Isabella and Rachel as they move on to the scholarship competition.
The Smoke Signal is pleased to announce it will host a screening of Pascack Valley alum Ken Spooner's documentary film Life with Layla on Tuesday, November 5th at 7 p.m. in our auditorium here at PV. Spooner, a 2008 PV grad, co-produced and co-directed the film with Steve McCarthy and Mike Mee, and the three will be on hand for a Q&A afterward. Admission is $5, and the Smoke Signal is donating all ticket proceeds to the filmmakers as they seek to bring the movie to a national audience. For more information, contact Katie Mullaney, Rachel Cohen, or Bill Rawson, or email pvsmokesignal@gmail.com. Back again is meteorologist Tyler McCune with the forecast for the upcoming four-day weekend.
Oh, did we start? Now here's Tyler for the weather. Oh, okay. So, thanks guys. Today we're going to have a high of 77 and a low of 58, sunny. And then tomorrow we're going to have a high of 83 and a low of 66, mostly sunny. Well, on Sunday we'll have a high of 79 and a low of 59, mostly sunny again. And since we have this nice long four-day weekend, let's toss in Monday and Tuesday as well. So Monday's going to have a high of 71 and a low of 59, partially cloudy, while Tuesday will have a high of 80 and low of 65, mostly cloudy. Thanks, and now back to you guys.
If you're interested in joining the debate team, see Ms. Johnson in room 115 or go to the lecture hall on Tuesdays after school for any more information. Pvtv reporter James Montgomery went around the school to see what people are doing over the four-day weekend. Let's take a look.
Back again is our sports reporter Jake Lutz with his recap of some key sporting events from the week.
Thanks guys, and welcome back to the PV Sports Network. First up, I caught up with the cross country team this past week to see how their season has been. The team has been having a solid season even throughout injuries and losing a lot of seniors. The freshman boys cross country team is off to a fantastic start, placing in almost every meet. I got to talk to the coaches and runners about how their season has been and what the goals are for the rest of the season.
My goals for the rest of the year is 1830, 5K, and for the team, freshman, JV, and varsity to all do well, injury-free regarding that.
For the rest of the year, I hope to just have a good season and enjoy the rest of my season and just have a fun time running without getting injured.
For the rest of the season, we'd like to get healthy, okay, first of all. And then as the season progresses here, just be in tip-top shape for those important races. We have coming up, we have our batch meet, our league meet, which are the two big ones against all the competition around here. Eventually we have the counties. So we have some big races coming up, so we'd like to be ready to rock and roll for those.
Next up, the boys football team moved down to 3-0 after defeating Paramus last Friday. The Indians' offense scored big again, scoring 38 points. Jake Williams rushed for 141 yards and two rushing touchdowns and also caught a 24-yard touchdown. Stephen Began passed for 200 yards and threw a touchdown pass to Jake Sioka and Jake Williams. The last touchdown scored by Desmond Von Tobel. Jake Sioka went a perfect 5-for-5 on field goals. Altogether, fantastic game from PV on both sides of the field.
Obviously, my goal is to go to MetLife, but every week it's different. It's like to go 1-0 every week and, you know, just have fun with my friends because it's probably one of my last times playing football with them.
We've just been practicing hard, you know, doing what we've been doing the first 3 weeks and getting after in practice so the game is easier.
This Saturday, the Valley has a homecoming barbecue that starts at 11:30 a.m. The football game starts at 1 o'clock after the barbecue.
Homecoming is always, like, important because it brings all the future, former, and right now students at PV all together and gives us a time to get together. The kids get to eat food and come watch some football.
Thank you. Homecoming is very special here at the Valley, you know. Get all the previous players here, get them to see PV, the new PV now, get them to see us play, get them a nice day.
Thank you. Wear green because it is a green out. Thanks again for tuning in. Back to you guys at the studio.
Our reporter Dan Large has the opportunity to interview one of PV's talented artists, Jude. Let's take a look.
How should I introduce you, do you think?
I'm here with Jude.
Jude?
I go by Jude.
Just go by Jude? Hey, PV. I'm here with Jude. Okay, so your real name's actually John.
My name is not John. Where did you get John?
Your name, okay,
my
sorry.
My name's Aiden.
All right, start over. Hi, I'm here with John Palemini. Tell us a little about yourself.
From Paramus. Paramus. I was born and raised there.
All right, that's enough.
Okay.
We got to keep this going. Sorry. Your music is just, you've played me some, it's just beautiful.
Thanks, man.
We'll play an audio clip right now.
Thanks.
That's it. So Jude here produces his own music. You release it on Spotify and iTunes?
Yeah.
Your stage name is Jude?
Yeah.
Okay, so when people want to find you, they look for Jude on iTunes?
Yeah.
And they'll find your songs?
It's just under Jude.
Can you be quiet? Like for once?
All right.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Is that like a joke?
No, I just gotta edit this and you're like kind of talking over. Oh.
Okay.
Yeah. What role did music play in your childhood?
It was kind of just always there. My dad was in a pretty successful band called mm-hmm. Boys Town in the late 80s and early 90s. And so it was just kind of always around there since I could think. I was listening to Beatles records.
Beatles. And you like the Beatles?
Like yeah.
Dude, the Beatles is great. Bohemian Rhapsody, We Didn't Start the Fire. You know? Yeah. Where do you get most of your inspiration?
Like if I see like a movie poster or like, just a combination of words that could be a title already.
I asked you to be quiet once already, and I told, I'm like, okay, we can't keep talking over each other like this. This clearly isn't working.
It's a real good show you got going, man.
Where can we find you?
Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube, Amazon, anywhere. Just search up One Way by Jude.
All right.
And the album will show up.
Now, where can we find your music? Who is your favorite artist?
That's a lot. I don't know if I could pick one. Paul McCartney, probably. What am I supposed to talk about?
Sorry. I forgot you were here. Where can we find you?
I told you that like 5 minutes ago.
I'm sensing some distress coming from
you.
This general direction.
I can't stand you.
You can't stand me. All right. Well, let's just get through the rest of these questions and then we'll go our separate ways. Thank you. Where can we find you? Thank you to Jude. I don't know where he decided to go, but back to you guys in the studio.
Finally, we have an all-new PVTV gate. This week, journalist Chris McGrath went to the vending machines to see how much the prices have risen as of late.
If you thought the sandwich price increase ended the money madness at PV, think again. Multiple items in the vending machine were increased, leading to kids not being able to purchase snacks for the former three-quarter price. Many of them were increased by 10 cents, while others were raised by 25. I went out to see how the students reacted to this epidemic.
Well, that's it for this edition of PVTV. I'm Brianna Olivera.
And I'm TJ Pellegrin. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.